tough, hard-fought game. I got a lot of respect for the coaches and players on the other side. They play the game the right way, and really proud of our team, proud of our fans. I thought that our fans showed up today, and I had a lot of them there in the stands. They continue to support us on the road, which I think is tremendous. And they're supporting a good cause because our players play really hard and physical in a tough place to play. The environment is always tough and challenging here. We thought that if we were able to run the ball early and pound away, it would take its toll in the second half, and I think that showed through. We've got a lot of places we can improve on, and just putting in some spurts of decent defense, but I'm also proud of the third down plays they were able to make that thought was the difference in the second half. Yeah, I think, you know, some people, if you're aggressive, we talked all week about no dumping. Then they had dumping. We got a kid pressing a guy that is wiring the guy, and he's don't tell him not to press him, he's pressing. So he wasn't like he was beat. We just had him so jammed up that he probably did too much. I don't get upset about those because that's a good sign. I worry about them when they can't press them. But I thought the kids played hard, overcame a lot of those penalties. Second half was really important. We came in and talked about what we wanted to do for the opener second half, and talked about how we wanted to try to grind the clock, and it wore down on them.
What are you concerned going into today's game?
I think young kids playing in the environment. We've got a lot of guys that played in big games like this before. It wasn't the Lamonts and the DeAndre Bakers. It was those guys affecting younger players, maybe Tyson Campbell, Jim Cannon, all young players who haven't had an opportunity to come in that environment. We talked a little bit about trust your training. Trust the fact that you worked out all summer in the heat. Trust the fact that we practice in the heat every day. Trust the fact that we make it very demanding in practice so that the game's easier. If you trust your training, then you'll overcome a lot. And there'll be highs and lows in the game, and be ebbs and flows, but we're just going to keep on chopping. And they were able to do that.
What were these specific reasons to you?
Well, I have to watch the tape, but I thought when he first went in, to watch him a couple plays, he looked physical at the point of attack. Cade's a competitor. Cade's been working at left tackle for a while now. We have to continue to develop offensive linemen because if that's who we want to be and we want to create that identity, we got to have more than five guys that can help run the ball and help pass pro. I thought he came in a tough situation to play, but
specifically in the second half, what were the adjustments? I mean, 21-0 run there on offense. In the third quarter, were there adjustments specifically you guys made coming out in that quarter, or was it doing what you do better?
It was doing what we did, cumulative effect. I mean, at the end of the day, it was just worn down. You guys always want to make it about adjustments, which I understand, but we stopped them 2-3 and outs, I think, maybe, and I think that was the backbreaker for your defense. You have to go out there and lean up against those big guys for that those two long drives just took it out of them. You can just see the air coming out of them a little bit as we drove down physically. Big stop of the game to me was either the first or second drive of the second half when we had 3rd and 2 or 3rd and 3. It stopped them and punted right back to us and the defense got back out there. That takes its toll. And I think our conditioning showed through, and a lot of credit goes to Coach Sinclair and his strength staff. They worked the kids hard all summer so they could prepare for second halves like that.
How big were those points going into the half and being able to actually put some points up in the second quarter?
I think it was good. It's a momentum deal for us. Get a little momentum going in. We play can swarm either way because if we miss it, they go in feeling good. And if we make it, we go in feeling much better. It gets a little cushion. And I thought we did a good job managing the clock there. It's a situation where we probably could have burned another timeout just to get one more play. But we just got to decide to take the field goal.
How is Nico continuing to get better than Prince?
Well, I think, you know, he's more of an inside threat than perimeter threat. Most of his threats came in the inside. And one of them, to be honest, wasn't so much what we did, they just busted the coverage. They had a dance, they busted coverage, we left him wide open, and Jake exposed for it.
Couple guys.
And I'll also say this, Miko's catch for a run, Tyler Simmons had one hell of a block. And that's the one thing our guys on the perimeter take pride in, they're physical. When you ask these other teams, 8, 87, 2, 9, 5, they hit you. And it wears down,
Can you take out there, Seth, and give them the views?
We preached it all week. You know, we didn't say it publicly, but we certainly felt like the hotter it was, the better off we'd be. I mean, we don't worry about what other people say. We worry about what we do. We practice at 3:30 every day, 4 o'clock. It's hot. We don't run from it. We work out the summer. It's hot. So the hotter it is, the deeper we are, the more guys we can play, and it takes its toll on our teams.
Coach,
Were you surprised they challenged Bank that much that early?
I don't know that they were challenging Bank as much as that was where the read went. You know, most of those balls were thrown into the boundary. He was into the boundary. And when they were on the other boundary, they went to Tyson Campbell. So I don't know that it was just going to Bank. It was just where the read took him.
Did he take it through?